Hello world, we are back in Warcraft, and as you can see, I have already prepared my hero skull for Lochmodan, and here we are. With Pilot Hammerfoot.
You got my attention.
Have our leaders finally heard my pleas? We are down to just a handful of pilots and mountaineers to defend Lochmodan. Okay. So that quest, it's usually like the hero call quest. It's usually just a pointer, right? It's not even. It usually doesn't have any story. My friend and fellow siege engine pilot, Mori Hildelf, is lost in the hills. We were looking for a rare ore that's needed for a high-grade blast powder. And during our search, he drove his engine up a steep hill and busted it. Still convinced that the ore was in these mountains, Hildelf charged me to guard our engines while he continued on foot. It's been days and I have heard some beastly growls north of Helm's Bed Lake, west of the tunnel. Morris, tough as nails, but I'm worried. Please find him.
Be good.
So, apparently they are using special ore. That's interesting. I'm thinking maybe... Could it be Azerite, actually? Like, I know Azerite was introduced in Battle for Azeroth, right? But he's talking about some rare ore, and I'm wondering if... like, that ore is not mentioned, I don't think, anywhere in the game, right? Like, I think it's something vague that they put into a quest log, right? Into quest text. That it actually doesn't matter lore-wise. But if we are thinking we as a miner, we mine almost everything, right? So there is nothing... I haven't seen any stuff like that, so I'm thinking maybe if we were to explain it to ourselves, right? Before Sargeras tapped Azeroth, the Azerite was very rare. Did it exist at all? Who knows? Who knows? It probably didn't exist at all, right? Anyway, I also wanted to comment on this dwarf. This is a sort of dwarf skeleton. Right? But this is like vanilla dwarf skeleton, I think. We have... we had recently all skeletons updated, but this one is still the old one. Like you can see, the quality is very poor. But anyway, we get a new weapon. It is beautiful. Oh, but the cloak is wonderful as well. Weapon has priority though, right? Right. Here is the corpse of a dwarf. Mouth frozen and picked clean by mountain scavengers. Clutched in its hand is a book containing the roughly scribbled notes of Mori Hildelf, and around its frame, still in superior condition, is a brigadier's vest. This grisly scene must have been where the siege engine pilot met his end. And apparently... before we were getting Brigadier's Vest as a quest reward for this quest. But it was changed. A Pilot's Revenge. Hildelf wrote in his journal that he was attacked by Mangeklaw, a huge... Menchklaw? A huge ice claw bear. Beer. Bear. He drove off the beast, but not before it mauled him savagely. Judging from the state of Hildelf's body, Menchklaw must have later returned and killed him. However, Hildelf wrote in his journal his one final wish. Revenge against Menchklaw. Look around Hildelf's body, the bear will certainly be nearby. And we will get a nice pantaloons. And the bear is dead. Okay. We, in the meantime, can equip our new weapon. Which is a mace. Which is better than the axe that we have, because... I am associating axes with barbarians, right? And maces with paladins and clerics, so that's... That is making way more sense. Also, love this description. Battle Axe of the Sober Dwarf. That's an oxymoron, lad. That is great. And I forgot to put these gauntlets as well. Nice. Oh, the bear is out. Bear?
I need to get closer.
Bear with me. So I actually, in the last episode I was saying that I'm not looking at other talents, that I will be looking at them once I level up. So I pick the one that interests me the most, but actually I did check some of them and it looks like we should have gone with Redoubt. Because eventually there is a bunch of stuff that decreases cooldown of the shield and increases its damage and all that cool stuff, so... But for now, the talent that we picked is still the best choice. Also, I wanted to read the journal. Sorry. Day 1. My tank is broken, but I know the Chiron's ore is in these hills somewhere. So it's Chiron ore. Chiron ore. Okay. I told Hammerfoot to stay and watch our tanks. We haven't heard from this about this ore ever since, right? I'm continuing the search alone. If I don't make it back, then this journal is my last testament. Buron Hildelf, Pilot Ironforge's Team Brigade. Day 2. My search continues. At no ore. I'm wondering if Stonegar was just making up the rumor of that ore as a joke. Well, if he did, then he's getting a cracked skull when I get back to Steel Grill's depot. Okay. So it's just a hoax. Tonight, as I prepared my camp, I heard a growl echoing through the canyons. It isn't a wolf. It might be a bear. Bear! Damn it! Bear! Day 3. That growling continued throughout the night and followed me all day, distracting me from my hunt for ore. I think there is a bear following me. I hope he comes close. I'll bury my pick into his head. Day 4. My supplies are running low. I still have plenty of food, but I didn't plan for such a long day in the wilds outside my tank and I only brought 2 kegs of ale with me. Beer! Not bear! I have been up all night the past 2 nights, listening to that cursed growling, and I have nearly drained my kegs dry. I'll have to head back to Hammerfoot and our steam tanks tomorrow. I don't want to get lost out here boozeless. The cursed bear did me in. It attacked me at midday, roaring and charging at me from behind. I would have smelled it coming had it charged from upwind. Its stench was something awful. The reek of its mangy coat and rotted bread alone nearly sent me spinning. I fought the thing off, but it chewed my leg up good. Now I can't move. My L's gone and I never did find that ore. Curses. Day 6. The bear hasn't yet returned. I must have given him a good beating, but I can still hear his growling. I think he is waiting for me to die. To whomever finds this book, I have a task for you. Kill that mangy bear. Kill it and take this book back to my friend Hammerfoot. He will want to know what happened. And take my armor. You will need it against old Menchclaw. So yeah, it used to be armor, not a weapon. Which is fun little detail. And also, I almost said that the bear wrote the book, so that's not ideal. Hello, Wojtek. Do you have word of my friend Hildelf? I do. He be dead. This is grim news, for Hildelf was a good friend, and I wish I could have been there with you when you found the beast, Menchclaw. Thank you, Wojtek. Your deed will be remembered by the pilots of the Ironforge Siege Brigade, ISB. Okay. We are due for sending a status report over to the Mountaineers in the Vale of Kings. I expect you are on your way there next anyhow. Would you mind dropping it off for me? Just take the tunnel to the east and check in at the guard station. Hand it directly to Captain Rugelfus.
Off with you.
Who knows? A report which cannot be read. I also think that the bear and the mountaineer used to be somewhere here. I could be wrong though. Okay. Moving to the Vale of Kings. I don't remember if these shakes happened before, like in vanilla era, or they were added with Cataclysm. I love dwarves. I'm a little bit disappointed. I guess you can make yourself look like that, right? If you look at appearances, there are some... they were in vanilla times, I'm sure. And probably on hunters more so than on paladin. Yeah, we are now in Frozen Throne era. Oh, I don't have this stuff unlocked. Oh, okay. I thought I did. Like, that's the questing gear for what do you call them? Dead Knights, right? But I guess maybe it's a color variant? Huh. No, he actually doesn't have access to that. Okay, that's interesting. Vale of Kings, and we should be getting a view of this. And this I love, because at the time, when I was just starting to play this game, I also just watched Lord of the Rings. And if you remember, there was... there were two statues there of Isildur, I think, and his son or something like that. Which looked similar to this. And I remember them very fondly because me and my friend, we used to collect chewing gum stickers. I'm not sure if you guys are familiar with this, but where I grew up, we used to have chewing gums, but they were not like... they had different tastes, right? And they were slightly bigger than regular Orbit chewing gum or chewing gum like that, right? They were bigger and they were covered in a sticker, and then in the regular cover, right? So we were buying these chewing gums and collecting stickers from them. And one of the stickers was of Isildur, of the statue of Isildur, and it was, I think, very rare. So we, when I left, I believe he gave me that sticker. I don't remember actually. I think he did. He was saying something like he can eventually get another one, like that the luck will permit it. Eventually, right? But I was moving to a country where those chewing gums did not exist, right? So that was a nice memory. Sadly, we had fallen out, and we are no longer friends. Sadness. I almost want to keep this axe just because it has that oxymoron. Okay, we will sell it. I also have this replica that we received from for when the Warcraft movie came out, right? And it's very cool. Very cool looking. I actually want to transmogrify my set into this. Maybe not the shield, but the sword is just beautiful. Look at that. Shield is great as well, but it's actually very big shield, and I want to keep my shield a little bit smaller, which may not work out. Right, we have... I want to keep shield like this size. And new shields. We are now going to look at shields. Like, this shield is great. I love it. This shield is great as well. That's from questing in Azuramist, I think. Like, this is way too big. I mean, it sort of works, but... I'm not sure. Oh my god. This is Zandalar shields, right? Those are great. This is probably from that Motherlode dungeon. Another great shield. The Lion shield. This medal should be probably hanging, not sticking out. And those are Kul'tiran's shields, which are great as well. Silverhand shields. Some great looking shields. I'm looking forward to collecting them. I feel like I'm wasting time again. But I just want to look at some shields. Deal with it. It's not like someone watches these videos anyway, so... Nice! Those are shields from warlords, right? I think so. I actually quite like them. Oh, and Sha shields from Pandaria and Siege of Orgrimmar. Throne of Thunder, I guess. Let's not have this shield when we met Tortolans. Yeah, Pandaria shields, I'm not. The Pandaria overall, I did not like Pandaria. I mentioned this before. I don't know why, but it's it just wasn't right for me. I also don't like weapons and shields with moving parts. Like, effects are fine, but moving parts, eh. Really? Yeah, I love shields. This is very beautiful shield. And we have Shield of Lord Iron. And it drops from Mal'Ganis in the Cullen of Stradholm. What I was looking for here? I just started talking about shields. This is great shield. This is with some Illidari runes. Okay. Nice silver moon shield. I think Vanilla had way too many shields. Like, if you look at it, there is a bunch of them. And this, I remember, I think it was like the best shield in the game in Vanilla. Skull Flame Shield. I'm not entirely sure, but I think it was like the best shield. Like, everyone was looking for it. If you look at this, like, this is Burning Crusade, right? And this is Zul'Group, so Zul'Group is still vanilla, I think. Yeah, Zul'Group is still vanilla, but yeah, some Blackwing Glaive and stuff like that, but I think this one, I want to say it dropped from Naxxramas, or I think it had like a serious quest line. Honestly, I have no idea. I never played that seriously, and I just remember there being a shield, and looking at it, it looks like it has a skull, so it should, thematically, it sort of belongs to Naxxramas. But at the same time, back then they didn't care that much about it's actually written down there that it's world drop, so it's very rare drop in vanilla. Anyway, we just wasted like 20 minutes looking at shields. At ease, human. This is no time for formalities. With the Alliance forces under attack, the protection of the dwarven territories becomes even more critical. The recent Trog uprising poses a dreadful threat to the king's land. What brings you all the way out here? I have a report for you. From Hammerfoot, I believe. The Southgate status report? Excellent. I've been waiting news from them for a while. With the increasing number of Trogs in the hills on all sides, I fear the outpost will be the first to feel any aggressive action. It's growing up. Identical shoes, okay. We need to protect the Loch, Wojtek. With so many of the king's soldiers fighting valiantly on remote battlefields, we have become overwhelmed on the home front. Trogs are tunneling up from every crevice. The Trog infestation poses the largest threat to Ironforge. We need you, brave adventurer, to venture forth and lay waste to the Trogs' threat. Slay 12 stone splitter Trogs and venture back. Okay.
Be good.
We will get boots for our trouble.
Well,
the Trog threat. Paladin, you may or may not be aware of the Trog threat looming over Dwarven lands. With the Ironforge reserve called up to the Alliance front, we are left with a fraction of the defense forces needed to keep those lands safe. My regiment is assigned to watch over the town here, and we cannot leave our post for fear of invasion. But we need some pressure put on those damn Trogs lurking in the hills. If you are up to the task, wage an assault on the Trogs, bring me back 8 Trog stone teeth as proof.
Keep your feet on the ground.
So I'm going to kill 12 Trogs and get 8 toots. So it's... I guess... Not all Trogs have teeth. Who knew? Also, I was looking at my chest piece. I think the red stuff is just the shirt that I have under it. And it's actually not part of the chest armor. I'm not sure if that is something interesting, but it's like... something that surprised me, because when I equipped the armor, I was like, oh, a red plate, wonderful. But it's actually not a red plate. Okay. There should be somewhere here. And there be other paladins and monks and warriors killing stuff. Okay.
It's too far away.
I can throw shit. Haha. Come. Okay. They hit him. But I think we are going into the cave because I don't want to compete with other players. Now, a sensible thing would be to invite them to party, but I don't want to. Like, you know that warning that pops up on the loading screen sometimes? That it is impolite to invite out of blue? That you should first talk to them? I don't want to. So that's what... That's why we are going into the cave. But it looks like... Yeah... The teeth drop only from the ones outside. Damn it. And I think actually this will be a next quest or something. To go inside the cave. Damn it. This is not working out as I wanted. Oh, it actually... I don't think it even counts them as... stone splinters. Okay. So back to the whale. and to tagging random trucks. But surely they will leave soon, right? Those guys that were killing everyone. But I guess not before killing everyone, actually. This area. And there are some. Okay. We can deal with this. I don't remember when trucks were updated, like their models. I think it was in Cataclysm. Because we had that... what was the zone called? Stonecore, I think. Deep Holm. Deep Core. It was here somewhere. Deep Holm, okay. And there is a huge storyline with trucks, I think, so... I think that's when they were updated. By the way, that Deep Holm zone is fun. So when we are going to play it, we are going to enjoy it immensely. Now these starting zones are fairly simplistic. I think we will start getting like some lore heavy quests, I think, in Wrath of the Lich King. Because even in Outland, I think it was very like simple. There were some stories, but they were usually short, and it was still about killing 10 rats and getting 12 berasses, right? So that's not exactly what we are looking for. Come on, you will die, and I will take your only tooth that you have in your mouth. Come on, hit him. I haven't seen blocks yet. Like, I'm not paying that much attention to my screen, but sound-wise, I also don't think I heard blocking sound, so... Well, to be honest, our chance to block is what? 25%, so that should be... Okay, that's actually, we should be hearing it all the time.
It's too far away.
But we can increase it even more with talents eventually. So that is going to be fun. I will try to get it as high as it can go. Like, I know there is also enchants for blocks. There are... I'm not sure if there are potions, actually. Can you drop a tooth, please? Because that would be great. Oh, that worked out nicely. Okay, and we are leaving this place, never to come back. Though I'm pretty sure we will get sent to kill that those shamans in the cave. Yay! Delightful. There are very few zones in Warcraft that I don't like, right? And I even like the Vashir zone, because I think it's very pretty. And I did not feel that combat or navigation in it is bad. Like, I actually quite enjoyed the zone. If I were to come up with zone that I don't like, I will be actually very hard pressed. I think I would end up with Pandaria zones. like most of them. I think only Dreadwastes I liked because there were Cluxy Council or whatever you call them, Elders. That storyline I enjoyed, but other than that, yeah, Pandaria is my least favorite zone.
What can I do for you?
Do you have 8 Trog Stone Teeth to show me? If not, there is still work to be done, Wojtek. Alright. I am quite impressed, Wojtek. You have done the Dwarven race a great favor by defending our lands. King Magni Bronzebeard himself would be proud.
See you soon.
Ooh. And we get Divine Shield, which has 5-minute cooldown. It grants immunity to all damage and harmful effects for 8 seconds. And it will give us forbearance. So that's our bubble, right? Okay.
What's on your mind?
Well done, Wojtek. You demonstrated uncanny courage on the battlefield. Our war against the Trogs will be won with efforts such as yours. You have served King Magni well. And we are getting back in there. Okay. It appears that these beasts in Lochmadan are following the lead of a chieftain named Gravmak. He is the biggest of all the Trogs here, lurking deep within the darkness of the caves to the north. If you feel yourself worthy, Wojtek, I want you to lead the assassination mission on Gravmak. And we will get an upgrade to our gear. The mountaineers tell me you are quite brave and capable, Wojtek. We need a human like you around here. The Trog problem isn't getting any better. The reserves have been called to the front and we are all alone out here. But now that we have a seasoned paladin here, let's see what you can do. Go out and kill 8 stone splinter shamans and 8 stone splinter bone snappers. You should find them in and around the cave in the southern mountains. Let's see if you live up to your reputation, Trog Slayer. Alright.
See you soon.
Let me also get rid of some gear. Mail, I will send it to someone. Same with leather. Plate. I can sell. Okay. And repair as well. So I'm running out of recording space again. I will finish this quest line. And then I will probably switch to Battle Chasers. Like I actually want to play this questing a little bit more. I quite enjoy it and I was hoping to make a serious dent into the, not only the zone, but like the entire playthrough today. But actually I have a lot of Warcraft videos already ready to get uploaded and only few Battle Chasers videos left. And also, as I mentioned, I'm running out of space to save those recordings, so I should prioritize Battle Chasers. But I like to play Battle Chasers at night or in the evening. So, you know. I'm also thinking about the next game to play after Battle Chasers. Though I still have like a long way to go to finish them. But I have been thinking about it and I know that horrors are quite popular, right? But I don't like to play them. Especially the ones where you, not the atmospheric horror, but the one where you have to run around like headless chicken. GOG sends me newsletter, right? So they mentioned there is a new sort of horror game on sale, so I was thinking about it, but then I was going through my library and I noticed that I already bought one from sale, but it's not what you would expect, right? It's an old game and it's actually more like, I would say, action adventure more than modern horror where you have to run away from monsters. So I think I will do that instead because that is more my speed. But we will see. Maybe I decide that I should play some horrors to get maybe it will be like my commentary will be more organic with games that I don't usually play than the ones that I know a lot of about. Yeah. On all Warcraft characters that I'm playing, I have this issue with cooldowns and resource management. And I can't figure out if I'm doing something wrong or if it's part of the game. Like, I feel I shouldn't be dealing with cooldowns. My mana, I don't think anything even uses mana. I think heals maybe, so I can spam them all the time. But yeah, I guess if abilities are not using mana, then the cooldowns are the only thing that is preventing me to go crazy on their asses, right? So that I guess makes sense. But I should be still looking into talents that decrease cooldown because I'm not a fan. Stop running around. Okay. Only few trucks left.
It's too far away.
Nice. Well, to be honest, I was about to say that I did where am I going? That I did make a serious dent with because I'm almost level 20, which is like what? 1/6 of the game. But I realized we are going through story mode of all zones. And that's actually not indicative at all, because you can level up without visiting several continents, alright? I actually, even before the scaling was introduced in Legion, I still managed to skip Pandaria because I would level up in Cataclysm and previous zones for so long that I would actually get high enough level to go straight into the Warlords, which today, to this day, are my favorite quest in continent. Even more than Northrend. Like, Northrend has a bunch of undead and nasty stuff that I don't particularly like, but Warlords, man, that's my, like, the prime barbarian zone. That is up my speed. And we haven't collected this dagger appearance yet. Okay, we will send it to someone who will collect it. I know. Nice letter opener. The simple vanilla weapons are not as impressive looking as weapons that we get later into since Wrath of the Lich King, right? I think Wrath of the Lich King is where we start getting like really cool looking weapons and armor. But I actually like vanilla stuff as well, because sometimes you feel like very silly when you have very flashy armor. And I actually don't like this kind of sets when you have... Let's look actually. Sets. Like this set that they introduced, I really like because it's very simple. And this set is fine. 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 This I feel is a little bit silly because it has that winged helmet. This as well is very way too complicated, especially for Paladin. This set I like, but I have no idea who should use it because it has fell, right? Which is not great. It's not Dead Knight set because it doesn't have skulls and undead or frost coming out of everywhere. It's not quite warrior because it has fell, right? And it, to be honest, it's a little spikeless for warrior. So I think it's best suited for Paladin, but at the same time, that fell is just way too distracting. I guess it's the best warrior set.
How are you?
Most excellent, Wojtek. You have brought hope to Lochmadan. With Gravmuk dead, we stand a better chance of seeing the Trogs eliminated from the land. Okay. Hold on.
What's on your mind?
I knew the second I laid eyes on you, Wojtek, that you would make Ironforge proud. You have served our people well. I salute you, Wojtek.
Safe travels.
He did not salute me at all. And you are going to send me to Telsamar, right? You have helped us quite a bit here. If you are leaving, I would ask you to take this status report up to Telsamar. Follow the road just north and you can't miss it. Mountaineer Cadrell will want the report.
Be good.
Okay, and let's equip all this new stuff. I think it's the same actually, like model-wise. Yeah.
How are you?
Let's sell what we don't need. Let's repair again. And now we can move out to Telsamar. So yeah. I mentioned this before, but I really like questing. I usually don't read quest objectives, like the flavor text that they have. I only read what I'm supposed to do, like kill, maim, collect and all that stuff. Yeah, it's like my favorite pastime, right? Like some people have fishing, some people have professions. If I'm bored with my main character, like I have grinded several war fronts in a row, like I did yesterday, right, and the day before, then I want to just cleanse my palette as it were with some leveling, and that's why I have a bunch of alts, and all of them are in different zones, right? I have one that is supposed to be in Northrend, one that is in Cataclysm, I think. Several that are in Legion. I think one is in Warlords. So yeah. I like going through the zone, killing just... It's like mindless a little bit, right? You just go complete quests and have fun. Oh yeah, here we go. A little dwarven village.
Well met.
Welcome to Telsamar, your home away from home in Lochmadan. Telsamar is a nice place, but it's not all beer and salted meat for those who answer the call of duty. Call to duty. If you are willing to face danger in the name of the Alliance, then read the poster outside the Telsamar branch of the Explorers League. What can I do for you? Is that a beer stain? It probably is. We are dealing with dwarves after all. Continue. Glad to hear you have been clearing out the drugs. Let's have a look at this report and... Is that a beer stain? It's not mine. And actually we are going to end our quest here. In the next episode... It will probably be reading with... Wojtek or reading with Agitated Crane, because I see two books and they usually quite long, right? So I will be reading that, talking a little bit about the lore. I think I saw Medivh here. The Last Guardian, right? So that's about Medivh. So we will also mention what we know about Medivh. What I know, which is not much, right, because I actually haven't read the books, which we definitely should. And also what the changes are in the movie, because I think it's a little bit different to what is in the lore, what we see in Karazhan, for example. And anyway, I hope you enjoyed the episode. If you did, leave a like, leave a comment, subscribe to the channel, share it with your friends. I have been Agitated Crane and we will be reading books in the next episode, so look forward to that. Goodbye.